What makes a city? People? Buildings? Horrific traffic jams? That's not too far off. It turns out that roads are what connect all the parts of a city. We need easy paths to travel from place to place and for moving materials, supplies, and services. And in some parts of cities, slums, that's not happening. The world's slums lack not only large, easy-to-travel roads, but they're also missing a lot of the infrastructure that goes along with them. Street signs, building numbers, and vehicle access to building exteriors. That lack of connectivity means that the billion people living in slums can't reliably get their mail, get to work, or even get to the hospital in an emergency. Trash removal and sanitation are difficult at best. Now, scientists are trying to transform slums with a mathematical approach to urban design called topology. Slums can be broken down into two components: infrastructure, like homes and stores, and the access network that links them, nodes and connections. With this framework, connections, in effect access, can be optimized. This new approach has already been used in two slums within Cape Town, South Africa. In one of the two neighborhoods, most essential services provided by the city, water, toilets, electricity, trash removal, are on the outskirts where road access exists. But the inner portions of the settlement, where temples are completely cut off. In this study, scientists used satellite data and detailed maps handmade by locals to diagram all the nodes and connections of the settlement. They then used their topological algorithm to figure out which areas were inaccessible by roads, then generated the most cost-effective ways to build roads and connect them to outside services. In topology, since one block of buildings surrounded by roads is considered equivalent, settlements with a wide range of shapes and sizes, from the suburbs of Las Vegas to the slums of Mumbai, can be analyzed in the same way. The scientists who designed the program hope to come up with a user-friendly interface that can be used by communities around the world. That, they say, would put the decision-making power into the hands of locals, who can determine if proposed access roads will accommodate their priorities, then reroute them accordingly.